you're there. This is Benjamin Dike, and I want to welcome you to Leading Edge, our series on leadership. I want to start with this. Have you ever been in a situation where you felt you couldn't effect a change? Maybe in your family, in your neighborhood, in your company or institution where you work, in the nation, you felt there could be something that could be changed, but you are not in the right position to do that because you didn't have the rank or the age. Today, this series will be for you. I want to share a few thoughts with you on what I've called leading from where you are. I read this unverified story a couple of years ago. It was something that was said that happened in New York City. So there was a tunnel, and a truck had gone into that tunnel and got stuck in the tunnel. It was carrying like a container on top of it. It got stuck there. And this happened just in the aftermath of the 9/11 terrorist incident in the US. And so people panicked because traffic started building up. The driver had seen what commotion had caused and left the vehicle and ran away. And so everybody was worried. Nobody knew what was inside the truck. And so they alerted the city authorities, and they were all there. They came, all the experts were there. The person that designed the tunnel was called in, and they were working feverishly, trying to figure out what to do. Should they lift the top of the tunnel? What would they do? How would they pull the truck out? While all this was going on, traffic was piling up, people were panicking. And it is said that there was a little boy who was playing by the side of the road. And he noticed all that commotion and approached an elderly person and asked, "Are you trying to bring out that truck from the tunnel?" And the person said, "Yes." And the little boy said, "Well, that's simple. Why don't you deflate the tires? And then you can bring out the truck." Listen, my friends. This was a solution that was there in plain sight, but nobody could see it. Because all the experts, they wanted to use the expert opinion to figure things out. My friend, it is a very limiting myth for you to think that you cannot influence unless you have a position or authority. Complex problems do not often require complex solutions. And that's what we miss it often. Because often expert opinions can be a limitation to bringing simple solutions to situations we face. Leadership can happen from anywhere in the organization. Leadership can come from anybody, as this young man in our story amply illustrates. I want to share four quick thoughts around this. Number one, as I've said, leadership can happen at any level in the organization. Breakthrough solutions are not age or position sensitive. It can come from anyone of any age and of any ranking within an organization. That is why great institutions strive in the openness that allows them to invite opinions and ideas from anyone within the organization. You know the Nokia story, the fall of Nokia. Part of what led to that fall was that the organization was rigid. It couldn't allow opinions from lower ranking people. But I can tell you, when you have a restrictive organization, the organization itself gets restricted. Their growth will get muted. But when you create openness that allows people to air their views, you will thrive because there will be diverse views that will come and you'll be able to pick some winning ideas. So you can lead from any part in the organization. Number two. Leadership thrives in the freshness of outlook that can come from people who may be non-experts. Right. What that means is that, you know, I used to make a joke, but I don't think it's a joke. It's a very serious thing. You can be looking at something for so long until you stop seeing. I'll say that again. You can be looking at something for so long until you stop seeing it. So sometimes to be able to make a great change, to create a great outcome, you may need a fresh pair of eyes. Sometimes you are working on a project and you are so consumed in it, consumed with your expertise, consumed with your background of all the things you have known about that issue, that you miss the big points there. But a fresh person looking at the same thing may bring some fresh perspective and create some winning ideas. So, Often, people can be stuck in that expertise that they miss the simple things that deliver great solutions. Never miss that. Number three, true leadership is functional. It is not positional. Now, this is very important. It is functional and not positional. Leadership based on rank or position is rudimentary. That's the elementary level of leadership, where your sense of leadership is only dependent on the position that you occupy. Position only confers very little leadership. Therefore, that's my submission. When you want to see true leadership is functional. In fact, I used to define leadership as what leaders do. So anyone that does the work of leadership becomes a leader. It is not the position that confers leadership. It is the function the person performs. That is what confers leadership. So I would then say leadership is a person, not a post or position. Leadership is a calling. It is not a gather. Leadership is getting the job done. It is not having the job title or the job role. So people do not have to follow you because of your position. Don't fall into that trap. They should rather follow you because of who you are. Remember what I said earlier. Leadership is what leaders do. It is not a position leaders occupy. You need to distinguish the two. Finally, number four, leaders are called to deliver solutions. So if you don't solve any problem, you are not leading. Right? So one of the basic functions of a leader is to provide solutions. In any organization, once there's a challenge, there's a crisis, a change has happened in the environment, and the people are looking for answers. Anyone who provides solution wears the badge of leadership. Let me say that again. Anyone who provides a solution wears the badge of leadership. Never forget that. So whoever solves a problem, that's a person that we recognize as the leader. And organizations today, families today, you know, neighborhoods today, nations today, they are in search of leadership because of the myriads of problems that are confronting people all over the place. All right, so let's recap again. So number one, I've said leadership can happen at any level in the organization. Number two, leadership thrives in the freshness of outlook. Number three, leadership is functional and not positional. And number four, leaders are called to deliver solutions. Let me close by saying this. The leadership starts with you. That is the essence of this whole discussion. Wherever you are, whoever you are, whatever your age, whatever is your position, leadership starts with you. You can make a change where you are. So let's not wait for the great experts to fix things. You may just be the person we have been waiting for. Leadership is influenced, like they say, and you can influence things from where you are. So my friend, if this session has been useful to you, please do subscribe on our YouTube channel and follow us in our various social media handles. Thank you so much. This has been Leading Edge. My name is Benjamin Dikey.